Okay, to start on the business end of the machine, we're going to start by removing the presser bar adjuster. Now there is that little washer over the top, so we're going to push that out with the spring, remove the spring. Change screwdriver bits. Then we'll remove the set screw. And the presser bar comes out the top. Now I've already cleaned these parts, so there's no struggle getting them out. Remove the block. I'm going to put the set screw back into the block, just so it doesn't get lost. Next item of business to come out, we will take off the screw that holds the lever in place for the presser bar. Set the screw with the lever there. Okay, next up is we're going to remove the needle bar, which is one of the reasons why I took all the stuff out of the hook area. You can see by turning this, you can see the action of the needle bar and the take-up lever mechanism is pretty cool. But in order to get the needle bar off, we have to remove the this thread guide down here on the bottom. To remove the needle clamp on the 201s as well as some of the model 15s, any of the machines that like the 1591 or ever that thread from right to left like the 201 does, there is a thread guide on the bottom facing towards the pillar that can make this a little tricky. So very carefully start by removing the set screw, setting it aside, and keeping a hand underneath it if you're going to do it in this orientation. Pull the screw out a little bit, still not ready to come, and it'll eventually come off, and you'll see that there's actually another little piece in here. I don't know how well you can see that. This little piece here, which fits inside the needle clamp, and set that aside. To remove the needle bar, you have to have the needle bar in the full down position. Behind the needle bar here, there's a hole, which is your access hole. You'll insert your screwdriver, find the screw heads, loosen the screw, and that will free up the needle bar. Now, in some cases, you might have to do a little remove this needle bar adjustment gauge before you can actually get the needle bar out. So I've got the needle bar loose. I'm popping the gauge off. Ooh, that's nice and slimy. And just slide the needle bar up into the little divot on the top. Now, like here, I can't get it out through the divot. I can't get it out through there either. So what I'm going to need to do is I'm going to need to use either a wooden punch, preferably a wooden punch. In this case, I happen to have a metal one that fits nicely. And then just give some ginger taps. Very carefully to tap this upper cap out of the way. You might not have to remove it all the way. Sometimes just getting it pushed up is enough. And I think in this case that will be. Yes, it is. I was able to lift the needle bar up and out. I will make a note as to what size this is and put that down in the item video description. I'm not going to sit here and measure it right this moment. Okay, next in line, let's get this back down. And this is a number 88. There's a hole here on the side. There is a set screw. Loosen the set screw in the hole. You don't have to remove it all the way, just loosen it. few turns. That's all it takes. I'll show you what that's going to remove in just a second. And this is a number, looks like a number 90 screwdriver bit. This screw here is not right-hand thread, it's left-hand thread. So to remove it, you turn it to the right, not to the left. This is a righty, loosey, lefty, tighty screw. Be very careful with it. These things are expensive if you can find them. That removes the linkage. Now we've loosened that set screw. There's another set screw right here on the side of the pillar. We're going to come in through the side here with a screwdriver. This one's hollow ground. I'll use this. It's got a little bit more oomph. Give it a twist. Just loosen the set screw. You don't have to remove it all the way. And that will allow you to lift out, if you got it loose enough, almost. Let me loosen that just a little bit more. Okay. You can remove that crank pin. And that should now allow us to remove the take-up arm and its associated crank pins. And that, my friends, is all there is to doing that portion. Now what's left is the fork, which is used to actuate the upper thread tension for loosening. So there's one screw here. Screw down. Now the spring is usually very well attached. If it comes loose, well, you'll have to struggle to get that back on. Now this particular machine, there is a set screw here. This one is now a hex head cap screw. This is what holds the stud for the upper thread tension. On this particular machine, that set screw was missing. And the hole was somewhat stripped, so I re-tapped it to a different size. I believe, not 100% confident, but I believe the original threads were at a 1028. So it would behoove you not to lose that screw. Like I said, the whole upper tension mechanism on this machine was just flopping in the breeze before I got to it. But anyway, that's how you get these apart. And putting it back together again is basically the reverse of that procedure. And in a minute, I will show you how I do it. Okay, to put it all back together, I start with the fork that controls the upper thread tension from the presser bar assembly. Get it located. Here's where a pair of curved tip tweezers come in real, real handy. It also makes it so much easier when you have the machine sitting on her back like this, standing up, to get everything in the proper orientation. Screw started. Switch over to the business end screwdriver. Not too tight. There's a shoulder on the screw. So you want to make sure the screw is sitting properly on the shoulder, and that's now working correctly. Okay, you remember the take-up arm assembly, how we had to get that apart. Now, on the shaft of the take-up arm, there is a flat that is ground. That flat is going to be aimed towards the set screw here. So we're going to drop this in. Actually, there's a good opportunity to give her just a little touch of oil. Use your needle oiler. Get a little bit of oil on there. You've already cleaned these parts, I'm presuming. All right, so we're going to aim that in and drop her down the hole. Okay, now I'm going to change to a more appropriate size screwdriver again. The question remains, how do you know you've got it pointed in the hole correctly for that flat? Well, the best way to do that is get the screwdriver started, and then just start moving the screwdriver a little bit until you feel it starting to make contact, and shift the pin around, and you'll find it hit. You can feel it hit the flat. It's going to be done partially by feel. You'll feel when it hits the flat. And you don't have to go super, you don't have to crank down on it super hard, just make it snug. That's all it takes. Okay, likewise, for this other crank, same deal. You have a flat machined into the crank. It's going to orient it correctly, but here, at least you can see what you're doing, and you can drop her in the hole, and stick your screwdriver in. You have a little bit more leverage with this here, you can feel. I'm feeling that that's in there correctly. It's not a problem. Nice and snug. So now, ta-da, that's correct. Moving over to the needle bar actuating linkages. There is a set screw on here. You generally don't have to mess with that. But I'm going to put that linkage on, bring that up out of the way. Now, taking the needle bar, getting the needle bar back up into that hole, I'm going to slide the needle bar pretty well through. I'm going to take the needle bar adjusting gauge, slip that back on, we'll adjust that later, and then slip the needle, that there's a flat ground into the back of the needle bar here as well. So you're going to aim that to the back, slip it in the hole, and make sure the needle bar is all the way down. Put in your screwdriver, and once again, jiggle the needle bar. We'll make adjustments to the needle bar height later. You can see that's the limit on the heights of the needle bar adjustment. And just get it snug. We're not going to tighten that up just yet because the adjustment comes with a needle in place. We take the retaining screw that we took off of that crank, that linkage assembly. Once again, screws, this is a opposite thread screw, so turn it to the left to tighten. You don't have to crank it, just get it snug. And that brings us up to the point where we're getting ready to put in the presser bar. So, presser bar arm goes in, and its retaining screw. Once again, this is shouldered, so just don't go blindly cranking these things in. Keep in mind there's a shoulder on the screw that's going to be engaging the bar itself. And if you have to go backwards to get the threads to start, there it goes. And we'll take a more appropriate screwdriver bit. Hard part's over. Okay, that's in. Notice how that engages the fork. Next step. Make sure that your set screw is not coming through on the sliding block. You might have to manually move that out of the way, get the sliding block in position, and insert the presser bar from the top straight on through. Height at this point is not important. That's an adjustment we'll make later. Just getting it in place, that's all that matters right at the moment. spring. Actually, show you a little trick. That little washer can be really easy to lose. Loosen that up, slide the presser bar up a little bit, seeing how everything's nice and clean. Put the washer over the bar, and then put the adjuster screw on. Then go ahead and drop it down ballpark area where it's going to live. And just snug this up. Like I said, we're going to be making adjustments to that later. That's just getting it in place. Now, while we have this pointed up in the air like that, needle bar all the way down, take a screwdriver and slide this little gauge up so that the top of the gauge lines up with this top line on that needle bar linkage when the needle bar is in the lowest position. You'll thank yourself now later for doing that now. Anyway, that's all there is for putting that back together. The hook area, I got to do some cleaning on. Oh, no, we're not done. Sorry. The fun part. Getting the needle clamp back on. This can be a bit of a challenge. Easiest way to do it, once again, is to have the machine in this position, is to place the thread guide into its hole, press it in place, then move the entire assembly over, loosen it up, and tighten up the needle bar clamp so that the little detent where the set screw is hitting is pretty much in the center. That way you don't lose your thread guide. And then put the set screw back in. This is always the biggest pain in the neck to do if the machine is sitting horizontal. With the machine sitting vertically, this is a piece of cake. But with the machine sitting horizontally, you will swear at it. I know I do. I've come up with new combinations of profanities just getting those clamps on, but doing it vertically like this, it's so simple. Anyway, that's the business end. We'll cover putting the hook area together in another segment.